2014, Crimea was a welcoming place for people of different nationalities and beliefs. There, people lived in peace, worked and studied without issues. They started their families and raised children. However, after Russian troops invaded the Crimean Peninsula, Crimeans began to be persecuted on political, religious, and ethnic grounds. Now you are about to hear several stories told by children whose fathers disappeared under violent circumstances after the occupation of Crimea.
Honestly, a really heartbreaking short that told this reality of several children and what they have to go through with their dad just being taken away from their home. And personally, I never knew this was a thing that happened. I knew in some places, but not in Crimea specifically. And it's really just one of those reminders of the things that are happening in the world that I am just not known and not given information about. But this was a really well done short in a sense that it gave you a really brief and short introduction, which essentially painted the exact picture that you needed to understand what was happening. And then to just kind of dive right into all of these stories and to hear children as young as 8 years old talk about their experience and the fact that that's one of the only memories that they have at that age, at that point, is just a heartbreaking thing to realize that that's what they're going to grow up with. And that's one of the images that is just going to be ingrained in their minds about the father. And so, yeah, it was just a really heartbreaking reminder of all these things that are happening. But the good thing that, or what was done well, I guess, in this short was the fact that they were able to fit in animations throughout to really illustrate what the children are talking about. So it's not necessarily 100% of the time just them talking to a camera. It's broken down and kind of bringing their memory back to life, even though in a sense, in this way, it's probably not something that they would ever want to look back on. But again, this is a really great way to educate other people and to kind of get the word out about what's happening and to hopefully have someone realize what's happening and then take action to kind of to bring the fathers back to the families. So overall, just a really great job with putting everything together. And again, a very meaningful and very important short that had to be made. So really great job.
I mean, what can you say? It's an incredible film. It's incredible. I can't thank you enough for making it. I didn't know any of this was going on there. You know, there are war crimes in lots of countries, but this, tearing fathers away from children and having it be from the point of view of the kids and having them tell their stories, what they saw, what they experienced, what they felt, what they feel now. I loved the combination of documentary film styling, documentary filming with the style of animation that was included in conjunction with the documentaries. It's really so beautifully done. And then, you know, at the end of each story with the sort of the dossier of this person's imprisonment, incarceration, or kidnapping. It's really gut-wrenching. Well, you can see I'm like, my eyes are glistening. I was on the verge of tears a number of times watching this. It's really upsetting. And it's something that everyone needs to see. Everyone needs to watch this, and everyone needs to know that these kinds of atrocities are happening, and what can we do to stop this, or what can we do to help, or what can we do to release these men, get them released. It's a beautiful film, so thank you for making it. It's really heartbreaking.
Sure. And the bravery of the children is extraordinary. You know, it's just the worst kind of thing. I mean, and this film is very timely, especially with the imminent Russian invasion and how they just, you know, step by step, just destroy these other cultures and civilizations. And it makes you be very, very grateful for the freedoms that we have here. For however draconian our laws may be.
So it's a really great and touching documentary. I thought the use of animation along with the interviews worked really well and definitely added to the storytelling and to the emotions. Really great job.
Extremely powerful piece. And by centering it on these five stories of these children, it provided some really powerful insight of what's happening in the country, but also not just logistics or facts, but the fullness of the experience as seen by the innocent members of society. And I think the heart of it is that injustice that the children and the families grapple with, and how that unjust injustice uproots families, it tears loved ones from their home, and it leaves this real questioning of morality, of how we deal with injustice and how we can act and move forward. I found the testimonies of each child deeply profound in how they navigate this injustice and also the grief of losing a parent. And there was an astounding amount of resilience and hope and this full awareness of corruption at the heart of government. So the wisdom that came from these young people and innocent generations and their awakening to imbalances being upheld through love, essentially, and the strength in holding on to their community and their loved ones.
This is an issue that I had, you know, no knowledge of prior to watching this, so I really appreciated the opportunity to learn more about this issue in Crimea. Give Me Back My Dad was a really great film, and I love the way you focused on the children of the prisoners, because I think that's just such a powerful angle to take, just to see how these arrests have been affecting the younger generation. And I thought that the use of animation was just so great, especially, you know, assuming this was made during the pandemic. I think it was a super creative way to still tell this story, despite not being able to, you know, be in the same room as the people you're interviewing or the subjects that are telling their stories. So I thought it was a really excellent way to just spread this message during a difficult time. So,
what
great job.
A powerful and impactful short film. So sad, the situation of these people in Crimea. So hopefully this film helps your message get out. I thought that the choice of having the children talk directly to camera was a very strong choice. It really drives home the reality of the consequences of these terrible actions, showing us the effects on these innocents that haven't done anything, and how these cruel actions are impacting the younger generation and all these other people. I like the use of animation in this, keeping it simple and just very straightforward images also helped underline the stories that are being told here. There was no fancy artwork. It was just helped us to visualize the stories that were coming out of these children's mouths, and helped drive the story home and make it more emotionally impactful. So yeah, the good soundtrack, like I said, it was a very powerful story, and the tools that you used to tell the story, I thought, were very effective and very well done. Yeah. Good luck with
this. This is a very excellently done film and very moving. And first of all, it's really great that this is getting out, because like I'll just say, for me as an American, you know, I don't know much about Crimean culture and I have seen very little about it. So seeing a film here being released about it is good for me. It's enlightening. And, you know, I had no idea what was going on there. And, you know, the fact that these stories are getting out, you know, with a very simple title, Give Me Back My Dad, you know, these shows about children that have lost their fathers. It's very easy to understand what it is that we're about to watch and what we're watching. And we get the meaning of it very quickly and very easily. So that's excellent communication there and excellent storytelling. And I love the style of the animation. It was so wonderful. And it was blended with, you know, live actions. We're seeing the faces of the actual children. We're seeing the photos of the fathers at the end of the segments. And, but then we're seeing all this wonderful animation around it. And each story has this different, has a different look and different style. It's really, really terrifically done. The storytelling is great. The animation is beautiful, and the piece is directed and edited really well. The score is great. All of the kids telling the stories do such a wonderful job. They're so just real and natural and communicate so well. You know, and it's so brave of them to come on this film, to come before the world and just tell these stories so easily for them. It just seems so easy for them to be able to do that. It just shows a lot of bravery for these kids. You know, my heart really goes to them. So, you know, thank you for making this, for enlightening me, enlightening the world. And it was just wonderfully done. And I hope the message gets out there and gets seen.